But now that we see that GDP is going up at a significant rate and the job market is strong, and whether you believe the numbers are cherry picked or they're real, and inflation's still coming down at the same time, that is the Goldilocks, right? That's the Goldilocks, everybody, the mythical Goldilocks. Now, the problem is, okay, so here's the thing. All right, so let me just whiteboard it because some people are visual people here, okay? Initially, we went through inflation is transitory, right? And then soft landing, lots of little terms that were thrown around. Well, for a while there, as inflation was still kind of upticking and kind of peaking a little bit, Powell and the Fed came out and were like, you know, we see a strong labor market. And we know that during post-COVID, we know that wages were going up big time, right? Wages were going up. Everybody, you know, these businesses cut everybody or held hiring during COVID. Then they come back out and all of a sudden there's all this government money and the interest rates are low and they're expanding. They need to hire people. So there's a massive hiring frenzy, right? And there's this competition. And now you're jumping from Meta over to Google and you are getting the same job for a $60,000 increase. Or you're jumping from Microsoft as an engineer to Apple and you're getting, you know, $100,000, whatever. So people were doing this. And these jobs, they were wanting to lock in the best people during this frenzy. So they were offering tons of money and benefits and crazy stuff. Then they hired all these people, everything was good. And then all of a sudden, rates kept going up. And money wasn't cheap anymore. And expanding started slowing down. And venture capitalism and investment started waning a bit, right? And then it was like, oh, now we start doing the layoffs, right? We lay off a lot of people that we replaced or that were new hires that were on probation, whatever the reason was. So, but the job market stayed strong. People were still finding work. There was something like, the average person that left a large, you know, tech company or that was fired found a job within like 9 days or some crazy how easy it was. It was like buying a house for a while there. So the labor market was strong. We saw wages going up, people making more money, people spending more money. And that was keeping inflation high, according to the Fed. So they said, we need to see a weaker labor market, less people working, less people making as much money, less spending. Less spending means prices will go down and inflation will come down as well, right? So they focused on rates being the answer, increased rates being what drives inflation down, to increased rates plus weaker labor market, right? So if rates are high, it's more expensive to borrow money, and there's less people making more money, right? Because the stronger the labor market is, the more competitive it is, the more the companies have to raise benefits and packages in order to attract people, and then everyone's hourly earnings, everyone's compensation and income goes up. Well, with a weaker labor market, there's less competition, and therefore we have less of those increases, less money. Okay, now that we've got that, so rates going up plus weaker labor market equals inflation down. All right. Not good for the economy in the short term, but good in the long term because you don't want hyperinflation, you don't want runaway inflation, you don't want sustained inflation at these certain levels, right? Well, over the past 4 months, something different has happened. And that is that the labor market is still hot, but prices are coming down. One of three reasons, but let's say one of two reasons initially. Number one, okay, rates, right? Rates are high. People that are buying houses or trying to buy houses are paying a lot more, therefore they have less disposable income. Less people are buying homes because they can't afford to mortgage them out. Therefore they go into renting, and renting is super high, less disposable income. Okay. People are going to repossessions on cars are getting at crazy levels. People are in credit card debt up to their ass, and student loan payments started back up. So is it rates? Number two, inflation data is BS, right? That could be a reason. Either they said it was too high to begin with, or sorry, they're saying it's too low. It's dropping, but they're just cherry picking the numbers, okay? Or number three, the U.S. economy is so strong, including the dollar, that imports and manufacturing are cheaper, meaning prices are lower. I don't quite buy that quite yet. So now that we got that out of the way, let's talk about what the whole point of the V-shape. So you get strong labor numbers, but here's a few pieces of info. If GDP is revised up to 5.2%. That's hyper-accelerated, right? That's crazy. 5.2% increase in GDP,
right?
If you've got that skyrocketing,
but you also have prices coming down, then a strong labor force
is actually a good thing. It's bad when prices are down. I mean, when prices are going up, because then you're not getting that equilibrium. But if you can somehow get a growing economy and a strong labor force contributes to a growing GDP, at the same time prices are dropping, even though they were at record highs, that's the Goldilocks. I'm not saying that it is at face value 100% true. There's a lot of shit that goes on behind the scenes we don't know about. There's a lot of shell games going on. There's reverse repos. There's a lot of hidden money. There's a lot of things. But on the surface, if you have a growing economy with a strong labor force and prices are cooling off, that is your Goldilocks. How is the labor market hot? No, not the labor market. Well, I guess you could say, I don't want to call it the labor market. The labor force, I should say. The market is the wrong word here. Labor market would imply that I'm talking about people that are getting hired. I meant the labor force. There you go. The labor force. So people that are there. We're seeing wages still going up, albeit slower than they were, but still increasing. We're seeing productivity up with labor costs down, which means these companies are cutting employees that are non-essential and productivity still going up while their labor costs are going down. And this is how things can flip. Originally, when prices were up, labor force was strong. The idea that cutting rates is good because that's going to bring us to that equilibrium. But when you turn into this, whether it's because the dollar's strong, whether it's because import exports, whether it's because of whatever factor, this, all of a sudden, you're like, well, now things are good. This is what we wanted. We got the Goldilocks. See, before, when GDP was stagnating, prices were up and the labor force was strong, the idea was keep the rates up until the labor force gets weak and that'll reverse everything else. Then cutting rates will help. Unfortunately, when you're sitting at this with elevated rates, if you were sitting at this with rates sitting at 2%, okay, now we're good to go.
But with rates at the terminal rate at 5.25%, it has to come down.
It can't stay this high forever, or else it'll stagnate the economy. But now the market, instead of pricing in rate cuts as a good thing, the longer this happens, the more potential rate cutting could be bad. Because if rates go down, money's cheap again, and instead of a recession where you want rates down to stimulate spending by making money more affordable and more accessible, now you're going to do it, and now the potential for prices to reverse and go back up is in play again. And now if prices are going up and you have these two things, now you're f***ed again. So it's a convoluted mess is, I think, the main point to take away from this.
Repeat after me. F*** your puts. F*** your calls. Jerome Powell has you by the balls. Everyone thinking there's a surprise rate hike. Come on, bro. It's just going to be me being hawkish for 45 minutes, and then the Bloomberg guy is going to ask me something, and I will tank the market.
Oh,
no.